blowjobs from multiple Brians hanging from the ceiling. This is a fantasy space in the future, baby, at kink.com.
Oh, it's gotta be go time for Night Attack, bringing you the best of the worst of the internet ever since 1776. Hello, beautiful folks. My name is Brian Brushwood, live in Austin, Texas. As always, joined by my BFF and OAK, it's JRY. What is going on, Justin Robert Young?
And for the audio listeners, what you often miss at the beginning of the show is on video, our illustrious producer, Bryce, shows some of the Photoshops that have come in over the last week. Can you put that one back up?
I don't even know that it's much of a Photoshop. It's literally just a picture of me wearing the diving suit a friend of mine gave me, although it is kind of funny. I'm wearing a Coast Guard diving suit with the mask flipped down and my glasses on, which you can't do when you're diving, but it is rather prominently displayed in the background, the golden play button from YouTube.
It's a criminal investigations division sheet that has Brian Brushwood alias Snake Dick or Freestyling, and then a lot of crimes. For whatever reason, it tickled my fancy. We always love everybody who sends in Photoshops, and it always makes that intro just that much sillier. Brian, welcome to yet another edition of Night Attack.
Oh my goodness, I'm so excited to be here. I put on my best button-up t-shirt. I almost took a shower. How do things go around here? How am I roped into this equation?
Well, Brian, you might not know it yet, but you've been selected for many Brians.
Oh my gosh. Oh, I heard that among the pool of us, one of us would be selected to one day appear on the Night Attack. We were led to believe it was a magical island that we would live on forever and ever.
We've been watching you for a very long time.
You didn't see the time I touched the...
Yep.
Oh, right, okay. I'm here anyway. That's all that matters.
And?
Well, okay. I mean, she... didn't, I mean, may not have been strictly human, but,
yep.
Okay.
And?
Oh, golly. I mean, you know, the whole robot-human division is getting very blurred now anyway, so,
yeah. No, the other one.
Yeah, no, I fucked a slug.
Yep. Anyway, we're gone. Bye. They disappear back to heaven.
Belt.
Are we actually going to do the belt this time, or are we going to find another reason to not pay out the belt?
No. Belt's on. I want it fair and square.
Chat Realmers sent in, they collaborated on a list of donors for the belt. So.
Oh, good. So we have a list.
If you keep doing it, we've got places that money can go.
Right, this is a little bit worrying. How have you been, Justin?
Oh, dude, man. It's been, holiday weekend. Bit of a weird one because Ashley was out of town, so we didn't exactly do a ton together or anything, right? But this is the beginning of a really kind of like busy summer. And I guess I've had busy summers the last couple years because this is con season. Normally I was laying that on top of Go Game stuff, which is always very, very busy. This time, turns out by taking away my Go Game schedule and putting it full-time into podcasting, I've only created more opportunities for me to go out on the road and do stuff. But I don't know, man. I feel like there's like, I kind of feel like we are of kindred souls because you just had to do something that would probably be just like a bump in the road back when you were on the road all the time in this big, crazy 24-hour little swing that you did and you were a little nervous about it. Now, like, I've done four crazy summers in a row. For whatever reason, now I'm a little nervous about this one.
Well, I mean, is it because you took a few weeks, months off or whatever? I mean, because again, it's like there's something about the fact when you spend months and years at a time only thinking in 6-hour increments, like 6 hours from now, I have to be up and headed to the airport. 6 hours from now, I have to be landing and get my bag. 6 hours from now, I have to be setting up the gig. 6 hours from now, I have to be partying with the people at the gig or whatever. Like, it is astonishing to me how fast that atrophies. And all of a sudden you become a guy walking around. And by the way, time out real quick. You're fairly new to this whole weekend without the wife scenario. I understand, you know, you're with your wife and it's totally comfortable. More pantsless time or less pantsless time when it's just you. And for whatever reason, whether it's bathing, whether it's just refusing to wear pants, like,
you know, I don't know specifically, because that's not ever really the troubling element of it. Like, it's not necessarily whether or not I have pants on. It's like my tendency to just like revert to a weird slug, not the slug that you
that I had consensual man slug relationations with.
Oh my God. But like, I just like, I'm just this corpulent animal that just like takes fried rice like a feed bag and just like turns it up as I like, and I'm like, well, I don't know. What if I watch the entire 6-part OJ documentary? It's for my career. And then I just roll over and I drink a million bottles of everything and I fall down and I wake up with a headache and I'm like, oh wow, this is what I was like before I met Ashley. Anyway, that's sad. I guess I should have some fried rice.
It's like the moment she leaves, you star in your own one-man sitcom and your special catchphrase is, there's no one to judge me.
I mean, I don't know if it's like, it's just literally, I don't know whether it's like a part of me that wants to indulge an old like form that I had. It doesn't ever make me feel good. It's not like I get out of those weekends and be like, yep, just another boys weekend by myself watching Netflix and eating fried rice.
Yeah, sure. Right on. Well, okay. So, tell me about your headspace head now for this next gig. Can you talk about this next gig?
I don't know, Brian.
Okay. Let's play a little game called No Way or That's the Truth.
Okay. All right. A great game. Bryce, do you have any theme music that you can maybe cue right up? It's our new, people love the games on this show, right? They love it when we play games. So this is our favorite game of Bryce. Do you have music?
All right. Well, I'll tell you what. In the meantime, let's explain to everyone how No Way or That's the Truth is played.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, I say to Bonnie, you can't see it, but I have a weapon. And then I say something about Justin or else. And then you say something. And then Justin says, oh, don't shoot your wife.
Yeah.
And that's it.
In fact, what Bonnie doesn't know is the game's already begun.
What am I supposed to say? In what context are these phrases?
Oh, I don't think Bonnie knows. This might be kind of fun.
Why don't you just ask me the questions instead of threatening your wife with a weapon?
Hold on. It's too late. You can't see what's below this, this laptop.
Oh, I know you've got a weapon over
all
there.
All right. Okay, so.
It's a snub-nosed pistol.
Okay. Have you been approached?
No way. Oh, wait. He's supposed to say that.
Oh, yeah. No. Okay. Jeez. Bonnie will never guess it, and I feel weird just saying it.
What?
Hey, no. Justin, are you doing anything political in the next couple of weeks?
Wait, what are my options again?
No way, or that's the truth.
That's the truth.
Wait.
And actually, here, Bryce, whenever I say either of them, just bring the music up really loud.
Okay. All right. Hey, are you going to travel for this?
That's the truth.
Hey, are you going to be involved with a major political organization?
That's the truth. Times two.
Oh, wait. Hold on. Is it? Are you going to two things?
That's the truth.
Wait a minute. Do two of these things? Man, the only thing weirder would be if it was a cross section with a major peer-to-peer network organization.
What does that even
mean? Is that a question? Because if so, that's the truth.
So are you playing a game of chess in which you pit the Republican and the Democratic establishments against each other, then releasing it as a pay-per-view special to be released on the BitTorrent peer-to-peer network?
No way.
Oh. Are you... Bear Share jury confirmed. Dr.
Yeah,
Payne
no,
says.
Finally, Nutella is going to...
Are you? Is it true that you'll be representing LimeWire to bring us live coverage? Lime coverage of the Democratic National Convention.
No way.
Oh, okay. Man, well, how could that get any better? Maybe. Oh, wait. Oh, hold on. Are you on tab to go represent freaking BitTorrent's new political division?
No, it's eDonkey. Just kidding. It is BitTorrent. So.
Al Jury Zero.
So here's the deal.
Hold on real quick. Time out. This just in. Click here for Rene Goo's politics.jury.2016.720p proper.diamond.avi.
So BitTorrent, they're not just for thieving anymore.
No. Well, and first of all, it was amazing because you had mentioned this might be in the works, and we covered it on Cord Killers. And yeah. I was like, oh my God, this is an actual news story that we're covering on Cord Killers, and Justin's a guy doing the thing. This is amazing to me. So you are, and you have already done something with BitTorrent? Yes, no, maybe.
I've been talking with them for a pretty long time. So the guy who's running it is awesome, and we wound up getting hooked up through DTNS. BitTorrent is going to launch they are putting together a live television news network. They are, Mitsula was literally in San Francisco and was waiting at a coffee shop, while I had the initial meeting with the BitTorrent people.
That is amazing.
So here's what's happening. BitTorrent, obviously a tremendous brand, a company that really wants to diversify what they are known for. They are putting time, money, and effort and putting good people behind a news network because they can. They own, in an era where, you know, I just cut my I just cut my cable, and now I have Sling, and they are launching their own portal for all these various different networks, BitTorrent is. They can now put together a news network. Literally all they have to do is hire talent, and they have everything else that they need for it, including the money to put together.
Yeah, they have branding, they have distribution, they have access. All they're looking for is talent. Do you know of any, Justin? Just kidding. Could not be more excited for you. Where's your headspace out on this? Because on the one hand, I mean, not only is BitTorrent a very exciting internet brand, but also you're going to go tear stuff up at two of the oldest establishments in the country.
Well, so BitTorrent is credentialed media for both the Philadelphia and Cleveland Republican and Democratic National Conventions, respectively. Apparently, at least I know in Cleveland, we are our set is right next to the New York Times.
Oh, it's going to be great. Wow.
So they are going to have me there. Full disclosure, and this is how much I love Night Attack and I love Diamond Club. There's no ink signed on any of this. Like, this is literally just the fact that, like, I have faith in the project. I want to make it happen. It is going to happen. I really want to be there. I believe a lot in this project. I believe that there is room for more voices that aren't just complete partisan hackery. I very much think that BitTorrent can fill a space that, you know, I know from doing politics, that there's a lot of people that are really frustrated by the fact that half the people that they see on MSNBC, CNN, Fox News, or even a lot of the big outlets on YouTube and on the web are just complete, like, I wear this shirt. Boo the other person. Boo them. I swear. I hate them.
Well, and specifically, it's all like, I'm an expert in what the other person thinks. They think kill all the people.
Yeah. And that's not me. That's not what I've ever found interesting. And I don't think it's what BitTorrent finds interesting. They want to do something that really fits a need that is not yet met. And I'm excited to help them do that. So the big rollout will be at the convention. So, man, we're only a couple weeks away, which shows you how much I have faith in them, because I know that they are doing a million different things to put it together. And the fact that we are still at this stage is you know, just shows you how much effort it takes to spin up an entire news network. But full disclosure, there might be some delays in the show, depending on when they want me to be on in terms of the analysis and stuff like that. Hopefully we'll be able to make it work, because I know that they very much believe in me as a internet personality. And we want to keep all the plates spinning. But
what are the schedules on upcoming conventions? Like the first one is which, Democrat or Republican?
First one is the Republican convention in Cleveland.
And it starts when?
That is not next week, but the week after.
Okay, so a couple weeks out. Man, dude, you and I both have nut up schedules. I'm doing a lecture, Justin. I'm doing a magic lecture. And I've always, I don't know how to put this. When I first got started in magic, there were people, pre-internet, there was only one way to learn magic. And it was either from getting books from other people, which was tedious and difficult and frustrating, or you could go to a magic lecture when the person would actually be there and perform. Nowadays, all that stuff is virtualized. But I think back from when I was 19 to like 23 years old, and it's like a magic lecture was the biggest thing in the world. This person would define the stuff and the bits that I would learn how to do. It was like a one-on-one. It was much like a peer-to-peer download of information from one person to another. And now I'm going to be doing one next week, and I got to tell you, I'm a little bit wound up. I don't know. It's even after doing this for 20 years, I it's hard for me to accept or believe that I have anything to say that's worth a damn to anybody.
How many magic lectures have you done?
Oh, somewhere between all of them and oh boy, have I done lectures? I take that back. I've done a few local lectures.
Somewhere between all of them and a Geordi LaForge,
and a little looking for stormtroopers on Tatooine. Somewhere around
there between all of them and a ham sandwich.
A ham sandwich that I miss my mouth on and look through. Well, and that's the weird part, right, is, yes, I toured doing the Scam Sasquatch and the Supernatural lecture, but that was a very, very precisely written, you know, I knew every single slide and I had everything all scripted out and all this stuff. This one is very much more like, do material that magicians, who I don't know if you know, can be a bit of a persnickety bunch, are all going to universally love, and then give them advice that they will all deeply value. Go.
So can we get the word out on where this is going to be?
Yeah, I think so. if you want to watch it, it's going to be a Penguin Magic lecture. That's right. So if you go to penguinmagic.com, I think that there's a opportunity. I guess they're live streaming some of it.
I think that's the point. The
whole point is to live stream it.
Yes, is that they live stream these lectures and they live stream these performances.
It is
a huge business for them. I know Andrew's done one. So if you go there to Penguin, you can search for Andrew Main's lecture and you can find that there. Listen, they're great guys. I love everybody at Penguin. We worked with Penguin a bunch. In fact, Tim Cherno, who now works at Penguin, used to be our main contact at his old job, and now works there. Alvo Stockman, I like calling him Alvo Stockman because that's his performance name. But he's an awesome guy, and you get to go to one of my favorite cities that I always wind up in.
Oh my God! Well, first of all, yes, we have to schedule everything out. I had not seen this before, Bonnie. Oh my God, Bonnie, you're gonna love this. I did not know where it was. You asked me literally today, and you're like, "Where is it?" I was like,
"All right, hey, whoa, hold on, let's dial it back, because you might not remember, but this has happened four times." I'm doing a lecture for Penguin. Oh, is it in Columbus? I don't know. I think it might be in Minneapolis or Georgia or something. I'm like, it's probably in Columbus. I don't know. I'll have to check it out. Second time. Is it in Columbus? I don't know. know. It could be in New York City. It could be in Los Angeles. Like, I don't know where it is. And then finally today, I'm like, hey, you're doing the Penguin Lecture. Is it in, where is it? And you're like, ooh, let me look it up. Fly into, Georgia. Okay, yeah. And then I collect to, look at this. Columbus, Ohio.
Which was all the more delicious because every time you're on the road, I assume you're in Ohio. But look, Bonnie, I have a caricature of me. Look at this. Hold on. There's a Brian Brushwood Live Eventbrite on there. Yes. I have a penguin caricature now. That's amazing.
Wow.
Wow. It looks like you are like this is a satanic version of you. You look like you're wearing like dark.
Well, okay. So here's what's interesting is they took a it looks like it was modeled on one photo from 2003. Like that pose is from a photo in 2003. That face is, I believe, from a photo shoot Bill Wadman did 4 or 5 years ago. But also it's got more of the I don't know. It's
also you look like you have a nose ring.
You know what? I'm going to add a nose ring. I'll get a nose ring.
You should actually get your nose pierced.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
I mean, like, otherwise they'd be upset.
Justin.
So here's the deal. Everybody go and buy this online lecture. They are like, there is nobody better in the business than Penguin at doing this. They've been doing it for a very, very long time. They're very successful with it. They know how to handle it. Brian's going to be amazing at it.
I guess.
I got to tell you, Brian's not the best at scheduling. I mean, he schedules a lot.
Okay, look, it's not fair. Look, if somebody's juggling three balls, and as long as they don't drop the ball, you're like, three
Brian,
balls
or
whatever.
I see you juggling two balls all the time. All right, time out.
Once you get to the eighth ball, and somebody
where
drops.
Where did all these other balls come from?
Bonnie's like, I normally see you juggling juggle two balls, and then you put one ball under a pillow so you can take a nap.
All right. Jeez. Okay. Hey, so anyway,
is this a thing with the scheduling?
No. I'm just saying Bonnie rolls her eyes and says that I'm not good at scheduling. I'm really good at scheduling one thing a week, two things a week, three things, four things, five things, six things, seven things. It's when the eight things get put in that I start to drop balls and then take naps.
Now, let me tell you about Brian.
Oh, so, let me tell you.
Wait, Bryce, music stinger for this. New segment, let me tell you about Brian.
Let me tell you about Brian.
Oh, it's time for Inappropriate Facts About Brian Brushwood. Bringing you your host, it's Bonnie Brushwood.
So Brian and I today, we're sitting there.
I just realized what you're going to tell.
Yeah. So, you know, Brian, if he has like three things in one day, then it's just like he doesn't have to think. He gets to turn off his brain for like a week.
Actually,
right?
Bonnie, let me pause it for 2 seconds. Bryce, can you just go to an extreme close up on Brian's face? Every crack and crevice in Brian's face as Bonnie tells her story. And Bonnie, go.
Okay. And so like yesterday and the day before, we had some very busy weekends, right? Like a very busy weekend, but the trash still has to get taken out. And then he comes in and he like, you know, I do everything else, but he's supposed to take out the trash. And the trash.
Is that the division of labor?
Yeah. Well, it's turned out to be that way. Okay. And then the trash is overflowing and everywhere.
Time out.
Yeah.
Whoa. This is not Brian defends himself. That's another segment.
Right,
that's another
a different
bit.
Segment.
This is, let me tell you something about Brian.
Okay. All right.
And so then he comes in and he goes, what is this? Really? And he points at the trash, like, because it's overflowing.
No.
And then I'm just
hold on.
And then I'm just like, what? And then meanwhile, the whole time. Oh, Brian's.
No, Bonnie, go!
No. Am I telling it wrong?
Go!
No. I'm going to let Brian take over because I think.
No! This is not. No! We've ended the segment. Play the theme
Sorry.
Song, Brian.
Sorry. It's all you. Go.
No.
Oh, we're done. We're done. We're out.
No, but the funny part, I think Brian will tell the rest really funny, though.
So, okay, let me give proper context. Everything Bonnie said.
No,
100%.
Hold on. Wait a minute.
Proper context. Music.
Welcome back to our new favorite segment. Brian defends himself.
Okay.
So, yes, we had a very busy weekend. We went to 4 Fourth of July parties. We killed 7 copperheads. We petted 2 donkeys. We saw 6 geese. We went fishing twice. We set up all the
partridge in a pear tree.
No. We all of these things happened. And we definitely went swimming in 3 different pools. Okay, so then today I get called away. We have to shoot stand-ups and all that stuff, and I come home and just everything is complete and utter chaos. My mom bought my 8-year-old a violin.
Yay!
Okay.
So
Penny's got a violin?
Nope. No.
Josie's got a violin.
Josie's got a violin, right? So get ready with that. Also, Bonnie is having the piano tuned. The guy is in the hallway of the house. It's a very open floor plan. The guy has apparently said, you guys need to keep it down. I'm putting in these super special earplugs, and I'm going to be tuning the piano. Also, they're assembling the violin. Josie's got friends over. Calliope, the 3-year-old's running around in circles. Penny is doing her best to control her deeply simmering jealousy over this whole situation. And I happen to walk by, and I go, and Bonnie hands me something to throw away, and I go to throw it away, and I look at it, and then Bonnie gives a ta-da motion to the overflowing trash, and she says, "You didn't take it out last night." And we're being quiet because the piano tuner is in the other room. So she
meanwhile, the piano tutor's like, see.
Oh, no.
See these people tear each other apart. I feed off their angst. I'm the piano tutor.
Well, that's just it, is he's moved to the lower register, right? So Bonnie goes, "You didn't take it out yesterday." And it goes, "Done." And then I was just like, "Oh, I'm sorry. Did I not do enough yesterday? Was going to mom and dad's for a 4th of July party, followed by cord killers and spoiler in time, and driving an hour out to west to the airport. We had to set up all the. We went fishing and then we came back. Done."
Then Brian and I just start cracking up.
If you have the means to have an argument while someone is tuning a piano in the background, I highly recommend it.
I also love that both of you going back and forth sounds so much like Harvey Fierstein. It's just like, David! I don't know why it's happening, David. Whatever.
4th of July, 2016 was a very special day. I took my children out to the ranch where they met donkeys and they petted goats.
Maybe aww. I don't call my lawyer. Whatever.
My children said, "I'm not sure if I could touch the goat." And I said, "Listen, honey, you do whatever you want. You touch as many goats as your heart desires."
But then Brian and I start laughing. Then we immediately point up to the studio and go, "I didn't talk."
Yeah. Well, but also, I'm afraid the dude's listening to us. It's like, in my mind, we're sniggering at his tuning. Like, oh my God, you know how long it took him to hit that C sharp?
Dude, there's no doubt that dude is all up in your business listening with his highly sensitive little ear things, right?
Oh my God, I didn't even think about
that. Oh, dude, I actually thought about that. I was like, dude, what's he need, an app? I mean, I've tuned a guitar. Bling, I guarantee you, the stuff in his ear was actually just to listen to everything that's not the tuning.
I do love the idea that you would be like Eric Clapton sure about how to tune an instrument. Like,
yeah, whatever. Yeah.
All right. Well, listen, we've done a lot of bits.
Not attack.
But I feel like there's really only one bit that matters, and that's the give us money bit. I'm Justin Robert Young. This is Brian Brushwood. We'd like you to give us money.
Well, specifically, we'd like to keep you in the loop, so to speak. And by the way, in the loop is a new sexual maneuver we figured out. How's that going again, Justin?
Well, that's where you go ahead and make a loop with your arm,
mm-hmm.
And then have sex with somebody.
But then you'd be out of the loop, right?
Well, no. Once that's the whole point. All right, so if you're going to really make a thing about it, here's in the loop. In the loop is one part sexual intercourse.
Right.
one part American Gladiator.
See, that's not the way I learned it when I was in sixth grade. It was that you have regular vanilla sex, but you update someone on gossip while you're doing it.
No, it's
you
this.
Keep them in the loop.
You make a loop with your arm, and you have sex with somebody. If at any time during the sex, your sexual partner is able to pull your hand away from your torso, the referee will blow a whistle and you will be deducted 1 point. If you can get to the end, you get 10 points. And now for the final scores, let's throw it to Mo. Mo? There were 9 points earned and 2 deducted. That means an in-the-loop score of 7 points.
God, I could tell you just nailed a reference I didn't get.
I mean, it was, well, I should have said guts before, but instead I said American Gladiators. It's fine. No, hey, well, patreon.com/nightattack. That's a thing, right?
Yeah, it sure is, man. I cannot express how life-changing and wonderful it is that 1,594 people appreciate our horseshit enough that they throw a few nickels our way. Everything matters. If you could do a dollar an episode, that's fantastic. We will do this forever and ever until the day we die. And we hope everybody who's listened for free has really enjoyed it. But if you want to cross over into that special realm of folks who are deepest into our heart, balls deep in our heart, we like to say. Yeah. Why don't you throw us a few nickels at patreon.com.
Balls deep in my heart. You'll be balls deep in my mind. You'll be balls deep for us to find that your balls are deep in me too.
My goodness.
Balls. Wait, isn't the nature of balls deep is that the balls are on the outside and that's how deep your shaft is in?
Not when we do it.
Because otherwise balls deep is only what? Maybe 2 inches deep? Officer.
Wait, calm down, snub nose.
Maybe 3 or 4 inches. I mean, how big are your balls?
Patreon.com/nightattack. Support the show that supports you emotionally and physically. If you've never been supported by us emotionally and physically, don't worry. We're getting to you. We can only go one person at a time. Patreon.com/nightattack. Apply directly to your forehead. Patreon.com/nightattack is counting on you. Without us, we will all fall apart. Just try it.
Hey, real quick, I think we should open up lines for this second segment that we're talking about. Is that a good idea? Okay, good. If you guys have anything to add to the next thing we're going to talk about here, we kind of had an idea for a freeform thing. A lot of you guys know that Justin and I got our start in the magic world. Justin as an editor-in-chief of a magic blog, me as some jackass ruining magic on the internet. The entire universe... all had the same idea at the same time. They all thought they would send me the same story. I got one literally an hour ago. Everybody sent me this, Polish, somebody injuring another person with a hand stab routine.
Well, that's because, Brian, one of the first things that you delighted the world with was your amazing faux viral video of you stabbing yourself in the hand, right?
Yeah. Speaking of which, I didn't even think to check on Reddit to see if somebody else had put that out there or whatever. But regardless, all of that's neither here nor there. Okay. So I have not watched it because I have no appetite for this because I live this shit every day. I used to live this shit every day. Now I live it once every 2 to 3 weeks. And I do the hand stab routine, but it's freaking terrifying. It's got this giant knife in there. And the whole time I'm obsessed. Well,
here we go. Just for people, especially people who are listening over audio, let's go ahead and just explain the trick in general. What we're doing is watching your faux viral version of it.
Yeah, okay. So there's a magic theme, and it's hard for people to imagine. But back in the late 90s, it first got started, I forget by who, but it was done with the letter receipt stabbers or whatever under paper bags. It's evolved over time, but it's basically Russian roulette with one knife and a bunch of blank cups. And if you do your job right, you'll slam down on the things that don't have the knife, and you will avoid the thing that has the knife.
If you want to find versions of this, it is called the smash and stab. And there are various ways to do it. But as Brian is about to explain, it revolves around you having this tension-filled moment where you are about to slam down on something. There's a big kind of explosion, and everybody clenches their butts, and you have not stabbed your hand until eventually you have not stabbed your hand enough to reveal the one gigantic, terrifying thing.
Right. So here's the weird part, and I don't think I brought this up beforehand, but I have a question for you, Justin.
Yeah.
There was a time in the early 90s, early 2000s, or late 90s, early 2000s, where you could do this effect on stage. You could do the entire setup, and it was such a foreign, outrageous, obviously dangerous stunt that the even with your hands out over four bags or cups or whatever, and you know there's a knife under one, and you slam your hand down, you would hear audible gasps as if they were fine ladies in the 1800s having the vapors who, oh, Lordy, and then you slam your hand down.
They would all clutch their pearls so hard it would turn to talcum powder.
Yes, exactly. So, but it was such a novel and new theme. So here's my question for you. Like, it caught like wildfire. And as you can imagine, there are people who did it safely and people who did it less safely. With the advent of the internet, people have collected all the unsafe ways where things go a bit askew.
Well, all right. So here's where I can come in. Let's go ahead and play for the video viewers what Brian's version, which is the faux version gone wrong, is. He turns his and this is actually why your routine is really, really good, is that you have this randomization effect of the Lazy Susan, at which point you find the one that you were going to slam your hand down on. You hope that this will be the beginning of the routine where you slam a bunch of empty ones. Instead, you, knowing when to get right to the point in a viral video, slam immediately down on the knife and then cut to you with a bloody bandaged hand.
Correct. And so go ahead. In this case, go ahead.
So when I was running iTricks, and I was the editor of iTricks.com, the world's leading magic blog, this was not a thing that was just like any other version of like people would screw up smash and stab on camera far more often than they wouldn't be able to like get out of a straight jacket on camera. Like, this is a trick that for whatever reason is glittering gold to try to do on television and has high stakes and is easy to screw up on television to devastatingly terrible results.
So here's my question is, let's say you want to count my fake version of this. There's maybe 4 or 5 epic smash and stab failure magic videos out there.
I would
there.
Say more. Got to be more, because there were 4 or 5 when I was running that stuff back in 2009.
Okay, well, I guess I'm saying like of the classic pantheon, of the best of the best, there's 4 or 5 of them that have collected 90.
Sure, yes. And yeah, if we're going to be making our Mount Rushmore of snap hand videos,
so,
sure.
But here's my question is, I honestly suspect that more people have seen the smash and stab video than have seen the actual original routine from anyone, anywhere, ever. Like, my guess is more people only know this as the knife routine magician screw up than they know it as the sum total of all magicians, including television, have ever done correctly.
Yes and no. I mean, I think that this is another one of those funny magician things that everybody, all magicians focus on, like, you know, all right, here. Magicians always get their little knickers and a twist because they're so frustrated about the fact that exposure happens. Oh, anybody can read about how the tricks are done. Exposure is the worst thing ever. If you care about learning how a trick is done, congratulations, you're a magician. That is all that it takes. If you have sought out how a trick is done, congratulations, you've crossed that moat. There's not a lot of tourists to the let's go ahead and Google how magic tricks are done. And similarly, not many random people have any cognitive count in their head whether or not this thing has gone well or gone poorly. Now, they might know that this is a trick that has gone poorly. They might have seen multiple versions of it, but at the same time, they might have seen multiple versions of it going well and just not registered it. Because, newsflash, most people don't give a rat's ass about magic at all, either cataloging effects, successful or negative.
It depresses me to confess. You're probably right. But okay. So, all right. I assume you've already seen this, right?
I have not actually. No.
Oh my God. Both of us are virgin eyes. Bonnie, have you seen this?
I've purposely avoided it.
Until tonight. Done. The piano's almost tuned. Done.
Yes, the piano tuner strikes again.
Okay, Bryce, what can you... I assume you watch this.
Nope.
Oh, right on. Wow. Do we know where this took place?
Poland, I think.
Poland is what I heard.
A Polish breakfast television presenter.
No. All right.
Oh my gosh. Poland. Hold on. First of all, shame on you, CNN. The official text from the CNN YouTube channel says a Polish breakfast television presenter hit the nail on the head, or in this case, the hand.
Okay. Okay. Hey, wait. Hold on. Are you ready for a rant? Here's a rant.
Okay, go.
No outlet. And I don't care if you are as trashy as TMZ or as Tony as the old gray lady, the New York Times. No writer can resist writing about magic without a magic pun. It is impossible. For whatever reason, whenever I would go ahead and catalog for itricks.com, a lot of plugs for itricks.com. Again, go visit itricks.com if you want magic blog updates. It was always, and it was even, by the way, And I almost don't even want to bring this up because this was something that was cleared up.
Oh, my God. My hands are about to burst into flames. I'm rubbing them so quickly. Keep going.
And the accuser was discredited. This was a situation that was blown over. But there was a major name in magic that was accused of a sexual assault. And in the stories about that, there was like, this magician couldn't make these charges disappear. It is impossible for whatever reason, the catnip for writers on that. And it was just because I had come at the point that I was writing iTricks. I was just out of J school, basically. I was like 2 years out of J school. And I'm just like, you're hacks. You're all hacks. And I know that none of you are going to care because this is on a magic blog. But know that I know that you were trained better and you should feel bad about what you're doing.
Smash cut to it's 3 a.m. and he's just like, ugh. Try to understand he's a hand-stabbed man.
try to understand.
All right, walk us through this, Bryce.
Yeah. Abra, abra, cadabra, this nail reached out and grabbed him.
See, we can all do it. All
right. I know, but it's crap. It's crap. It's lazy writing, and you deserve to feel bad. All right, so here we go. By the way, here, another quick note. Isn't it amazing that CNN, as a journalistic entity, gets to just free boot videos,
and yeah, everybody's super with cool with it?
And we're like, okay, and time out on everything. I don't understand why none of the rules of copyright or television is nothing but reality television. It's reality TV. They audition new stories that they've largely manufactured with clips that they had to edit on the fly. And if it takes root, then they run with it and they give it its own show. Casey Anthony, the show. You loved it in our pilot season. Now it's happening for real. We're the news. Sorry.
I don't know where that went.
I have sex with the news.
Casey Anthony. Oh, what is she up to now?
All right, so this is the video. This is, CNN has copied this from 9.com.
All right, hey, listen, I'm sorry. Like, she made her baby disappear. Okay.
Oh, no, oh my God! No, stop! No.
Just play the video!
No!
I was crossing a line.
Z prawdziwym metalowym.
All right, pause.
Oh, boy.
Okay. The first
he
magic
has the
trick.
Opposite hair of you, Bryce.
Yeah, and here's the problem. I'm the last of holy shit. Like, actually, it's exactly inverted. He's bald with a ponytail. I had hair
That's a mullet.
And no ponytail.
He's got a mullet, I think.
Like think Hare Krishna, basically, right?
Yeah, yeah, no, definitely a Hare Krishna look. He has a full beard. Brian does not. This is, like, he has totally Brian Nega hair.
Yeah, well, and also Brian Nega outfit with, he's got a bow tie yeah. and flipping dolphins on his starched white shirt and a bigger beard than I could ever grow. By the way, if this person
and
is watching... Oh, and a gauge. I never had gauge. If this person is watching, allow me to say, I feel your pain. The whole world is criticizing your look.
Yeah, you should do better than that.
Yeah. I mean, mostly us, but like also should the whole thing. Let's just make them complicit.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Z prawdziwym metalowym gościem. Jakbyś mogła sprawdzić, czy jest ostry.
Jest ostry.
Jest? No. Będzie mniej boleć.
Okay, they're verifying it's a very sharp nail.
Wpuściliśmy? No ładnie.
Za chwileczkę każdy z nas losowo wybierze jedną torbę.
This is the very basic version of smash and stab. It is one letter, like nail, like so, like something that you would just put mail in, right? Like you would just like stab it down on one nail. He has put it in paper bags, and he is now randomizing them in front of the two hosts.
Zamieszam, tak żebyście...
Ja nie chcę tej z gwoździem.
Nie chcesz tej z gwoździem?
Może kacie się, że on na tym każdy
okay,
nie siadać.
Pause. Considering he's the one shuffling them, like the whole point of this is that nobody knows where anything is. Normally, the whole point is you have somebody else shuffle them, so you're like, the magician.
Literally, we're going to criticize his magic technique. Like, you know, he's about to have the most scarring moment in his entire political history.
Time out. BioCow is shouting fake in the chat, and I saw legitimately on Reddit, I didn't watch the video, but I did see people shouting fake and giving justification. So I look forward to, you know, I don't know.
Listen, I will not. I have not seen this. I will be happy to call this fake if it rings fake to me.
I hope it's fake. Please be fake.
Okay, so now we've cut to Team Skullet slamming it down on one. And now we're down to three bags where one has the nail in it.
And this is cut down because I think the original was maybe four or five.
Oh, sure, long. Sure. Which I guess you could do when you're CNN. And also it's like, bleh, their lawyers are in on the other side of the country. Oh, never mind. okay. This whole thing of grabbing other people's hands and slamming it down.
Yeah.
Not great.
Okay, but this is the intoxicating element of this trick, right? Because especially on these morning shows, where it happens a lot, by the way, you are able to bring other people into what should be a magic trick. Again, and just to spoil any illusions with illusions, magic tricks are not, maybe, they are all like...
Oh, yeah, rigorous. Time out. We're not going to say how all these are done, because again, you're right, there's a million different ways. Let me tell you ways it's not done. It's not done by, gravity will make it lean a certain way, so you're probably going to be able to tell which is which. I bet you just look which way it kind of leans.
Yeah, Kuhan says in the chat room, Justin, you're a magician and a former magic journalist. You're going to criticize his magic technique. Number one, how dare you? How dare you? Okay. I am not a magician. That's gross and
how
weird.
How dare you call me a magician?
Never, ever, ever. Never will I. Hashtag never magician. I covered them in the same way that Jack Hanna would cover zoo animals, and I brought them to the rest of the world.
And you know what?
Never learned a magic trick.
I'll have you know, I'm a political correspondent, sir. Call me not a magician.
I'm just, listen. Here's the funny thing. When you cover magic for like 5 years, you will not believe how many people, well-respected, famous television magicians, will just say, so, do you know how that was done? Nope. Do you want to find out? Nope. It was a double. We found, and it was his sister, and like, oh, cool. And they're so upset If you want to learn how magic tricks are done,
just don't
literally
care.
Just be friends with magician and don't care. Just have no care in the world. They will just spill them to you because they're all very clever.
Against don't care, there is no defense. Much like this local morning talk show host.
All right, so here we go. Out of three bags, the center one.
Okay.
Team Skullet slams the woman's hand down.
Oh, 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 oh! All right.
So we rewatched that second slam, and she has faked a scream like she has hit the nail.
I don't think that was a fake. You can clearly see the nail.
Oh, hello. Welcome to the party.
Kurwa, przepraszam.
Look at that guy's face. Oh,
przebiłem
my gosh.
Mi rękę. Naprawdę, przebiłem mi rękę. Przepraszam.
Okay.
Ała, to bolało. Słuchajcie, to bolało, ała.
Okay. I'm gonna call it on
the
audio.
Okay, wait a minute. Can we go back?
Oh, the poor girl.
By the way, first of all, Test in the chat room says, T2T2 translates. That's racist.
That's also racist. Well, I don't want to spoil how this trick is often done.
Oh.
But I heard something metallic hit the table from the magician's hand, as if he were slamming something down in disgust.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know the method you're referring to here. Rewind it. Let's look at the.
Oh, he drops a nail. Okay.
He doesn't pick it up.
Okay. Yeah. My shot has gone a little fuzzy.
Yeah. He takes it out.
Okay. That reaction. And by the way, keep in mind, this is coming from somebody who has faked this effect. I could not use after two or three takes. I did not have a single take that was good enough that I felt did not reek of fake. And the way I made mine look, you can you cut to my fake thing?
Yeah, let's just say, but can you go to where,
all right, well here, real quick, just listen to the audio of me right here.
And then I make my psychic selection, and if all goes well,
All right, but what you don't hear is that I had to go out and mute my own response because my own response was too fast because I slammed down and I go, and so I removed the first yell and you got something that I did not mean to do, but feels much more realistic, right?
The psychic selection, and if all goes well,
muted.
Oh,
and then the rest of the audio. So the reactions I'm seeing seem too difficult for all three characters.
Can we go back to the shot where she slams her hand on it?
Yep. Here comes.
Because I just want to see where the shot is with her hand.
Okay.
You cannot. Listen, I don't want to get into it.
Oh.
There's a reason why all you see of Brian's hand when he slams it down is his palm. And not the back of his hand.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think it's talking out of school to say I stuck a blade to the back of my hand. But she's showing her palm. And also, look at her reaction. I guess she slams it down. He sees it and is horrified and yanks it like it's a filthy secret out of her hand. And she screams. Watch this. All right. And then watch this. He sees what it is. He reacts. And then just yanks it out like he's a surgeon.
This, for me, the look to the camera sells it for me. Like, his look when he's just like, oh shit.
Oh, wait. Somebody got the belt. That isn't me.
Oh, damn.
I
couldn't get to winning it fast enough.
Ben Franklin clearly has not watched this in.
No, I love it. I love his method. Is that was clearly him putting it into her hand. As
his reaction is just delayed enough.
Well, and plus, also, here's the funny part, and I understand people who call it fake, because it was Bonnie's dad has all, I guess at some point he read a quote from Ronald Reagan that says, when you get busted doing something wrong, just look like an owl.
No, when you've behaved like an ass, look like an owl.
Now, there you
That's
go.
The quote.
Like, and now look at his face the moment he realizes, he turns and mugs to the camera looking like an owl. Oh, back before this, but even before that, there you go. He goes,
oh. Okay, number one, if you think this is fake, can I just explain how hilariously wrong you are?
Oh my God.
There is 0.0% chance this is fake. Because, Brian, please explain to people how really excited these morning show hosts are to play along with your magic trick.
Oh, dude, no, you will get zero cooperation, and you have to assume a 50% failure rate on the most basic of instructions that you give literally anyone. It is, let me remind you that it's 6:30 in the goddamn morning if you're on the show, and this is the life they lead.
And although the idea of the magician who only screws up morning show appearances with just these elaborately great magic techniques that you are only trying to fake the disaster.
I mean, this is not
that's a brilliant idea, and someone should do that. Someone should do that immediately. In fact, Brian, people should be linking back to this moment in this episode because you've come up with this idea and you have decided to become a super famous person by coming up with these brilliant magic routines where you can fake disasters.
I mean, just get ready for me to say, hey there, down in the ground, it's Beechwood, the dumb clown.
Like, that's a great idea. This person did not do that. That, like the, if that's fake, the method for which that being fake is brilliant. And I can't even come close to thinking how they did it.
I mean, the problem is that this is a fairly well-known method. It's definitely not fake.
Well, here's the other thing. Is like, and so we don't need to get into the method on it, but most magic tricks, and again, when you are a performer who has polished, you turn off your brain a little bit because it actually makes the show better if you're not thinking about it. Most magic tricks are all variations of delay, 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 I find it.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, and the whole time you're talking and thinking, you're keeping track of where the thing is, right? It's like, target's over here. I'm looking for the next zinger. I'm looking for the next volunteer. Also, the target's over there. This is the thing. This is the thing. And the target's over there. And finally, it's time for me to, I found the thing.
Yeah. In this, it is avoid, 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 I find it. So if you turn your brain off, it will always default to find it. It will always default to there it is, especially if you have techniques that lead you to where it is. It's always going to be in your head that that's where it is, and you are always going to want to go there. And that's why I think this thing gets screwed up so regularly. And again, I have watched more of these videos than anybody in the chat room, I can almost guarantee you. I have watched more of them than Brian, I can almost guarantee you. Like, there is an entire, you can probably still go to a hashtag on iTrix, just hashtag smash and stab, and you will find a litany of these videos.
Yeah, so, well, now I kind of want to, yeah, so anyway, that's real. Now we've watched it.
Oh, no, no, that's really real. Oh, no, Tess, no, what about Andrew? This is Andrew's theory on why this goes wrong so often. Is that this is like, that it is, you are going against your hardwiring.
Well, and
as a magician.
To be honest, like, as somebody who does this in the stage show, your only thought the entire time is not that one, not that one, not that one, not that one. And if you tune out for a second, You're like, oh, that girl over there, this guy over here, setting up the next routine. Ooh, the sound cue is off. Something's sideways. I would imagine being up at 6 in the morning doing a morning show or whatever, there's a number of distractions. You got people waving their hands and stuff at you. You snap back to where you are. You're like, oh, what was I thinking about? I'm like, oh, yeah, that one. And then you just, I could totally imagine. There have been times I've snapped awake in the middle of the routine And it was, it's a terrifying moment.
Oh, I was just about to post this, the exact same thing that T2T2 just posted, which is me writing about you.
Oh my God, what did you say? Yes!
2009.
Oh my God.
Each weekday, we have one of our iTricks.tv staff members select one of the recently uploaded videos, post it here on the front page, and explain why it's awesome. Today, that staff member is Adam, and the video is Brian Brushwood failed smash and stab. He writes, Brian takes what appears to be a quick demo of the same old Russian roulette routine and makes it look like it took a wrong turn.
That's great. Oh, I'm so glad we became friends before this video posted. Otherwise, I'd be on CNN. With a pre-booted video.
No, go ahead. No, take a look at that tag, man. There is at least probably a dozen of these videos up on iTricks. This is a scourge amongst the magic world.
Yeah, dude.
Keith Barry did it on TV. Scroll back up a little bit. Keith Barry did it.
Scroll down.
Oh, with Redman and Sam Jackson.
What?
Oh, it's probably taken down.
Bum, 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 bum. Wow.
Man. I mean, you want to do it right now? Do you have the stuff? You want to do it with Bonnie?
We already talked about what I'm going to do with Bonnie. Oh, it's not a smash.
Calm down, snub nose.
Balls deep. Balls deep smash and stab.
Yep, all 2 inches.
Whoa, what are we talking about?
Brian, what do you say we go ahead and take a look at the movie draft minute?
Presented by CosmicRadio.tv for the week of July 4th, 2016. I'm your host, Roberto Villegas. Folks, if my voice sounds a little different, that's because it's still recovering from RTX. So without further ado, let's go check the scoreboard. Team We Have Concerns is in sixth place with $136.6 million. Team Corkills is in fifth place with Legend of Tarzan bringing $45.5 million a week, and The Purge Electioneer bringing $34.7 million a week, bringing their total to $356.3 million. Team Nightac is in fourth place with $477.9 million. Team DTNS is in third place with $503.7 million. Team Metrekkers in second place with $601 million, and in first place with $612.6 million. It's Team Chainsaw Suit. And that is your Movie Drive Minute for the week of July 4th, 2016.
Hey, Brian, how uncomfortable are you made by the fact that Finding Dory is poised to be the highest grossing movie of the summer?
Zero. Zero, zero, zero. Because let's say it makes $50 million more dollars, right? That means in order to beat him, we'll have to make $200 million. Which I'm pretty sure Ghostbusters plus Secret Life of Pets is going to do. Let's say it makes $100 million more dollars. Pretty sure the two of those will make $250 million.
I don't know, Bri. I'm going to feed off your confidence on this one because I'm becoming a little scared of the situation.
Meanwhile, it's DTNS you have to worry about. Amtrekkers out of fuel. Chainsaw Suit's out of fuel. Oh, that's right. Keep in mind, Finding Dory isn't even in first place. So it's like, it's fine. It's fine.
I mean, until next week. Like, next week it'll be in first place.
Yes. But you know what won't be in first place is Finding Dory. It'll be, what is it? Definitely closed this crap. It's Ghostbusters this week, right?
No, Ghostbusters.
Secret
is like
Life of Pets. Secret Life of Pets will, we are totally screwed if Secret Life of Pets on its premiere can't usurp.
Takes a dump.
Yeah. If it cannot usurp Finding Dory, it's all over and DTNS is one. It's only a two team race at this point.
Also, Brian.
Yeah.
I may have been a naughty boy.
Uh-oh.
Read up on a plot breakdown of the new Ghostbusters movie.
Oh no, please don't say it's terrible. You're gonna say it's terrible, aren't you? Listen, say whatever you feel about it, but just please don't say it's terrible.
Bustin' made me feel good. I mean, listen, it's a comedy, right? Comedies aren't necessarily plot driven. There's a lot of funny things that can happen in kind of a silly or dumb plot. And who knows whether or not it's real. It was some stuff posted on Reddit. So who knows whether or not it's the real thing. Based on the trailers, it very much looks like the real thing. But Who knows? There was a bunch of dumb plot stuff posted about Batman versus Superman that didn't wind up happening. Let's fleck this by letting everybody know that Diamond Time is where you can have your project shouted out. DiamondClub.reddit.com or reddit.com/r/DiamondClub is where you can post your projects at the sticky post right at the top of the page. We begin with Zihuri. The world's top video game speedrunners have converged on Minneapolis, Minnesota for SGDQ, Summer Games Done Quick, which is a biannual marathon to raise money for charity. Do you like video games? Would you like to see your mind blown to see your favorite games defeated in mere moments? Well, check out the SGDQ Marathon. You will see Super Mario Bros. 3 100% completion in just over an hour. You will see the top players race over Super Metroid. You will see a lot more if you watch. And be sure to donate because it's a great cause. For all the information, go to gamesdonequick.com. 100% of the proceeds go to the Mersin Sans Frontiers, also known as Doctors Without Borders. Jesus, man. Thank you for putting that in there. It is happening the entire week. There's also many donation incentives and prizes to be given away to those who donate. So to get started, go to gamesdonequick.com. Links to the 24/7 live stream and the 24/7 chat are there, as well as information on donating to an awesome cause. That is Zach Hawari, Zach in the chat room. And before California Carl says anything, go to bit.ly/GDQ420swag.
Oh, yeah. Spiderbite writes, "Hey, y'all, I'm using my spot to plug Mike TV's Patreon. We've had him do so much music for us over time, and he's so good, it's almost unfair. In fact, I take it back, it is unfair. So support his stuff at patreon.com/YOLO420.com. Oh, I'm sorry, his Patreon is at YOLO420.com/reparationswag.
It's easier to just say
Patreon. Or just go to patreon.com/getsetgo. That's what I thought we were headed towards. Yeah, patreon.com/getsetgo. Mike TV is supremely talented, and we got to get him back any moment now.
He's the best. And meanwhile, Twan Twan writes, "Hello, Diamond Group. My wife is trying to start her own podcast about being a parent, healthy living, yoga. It's kind of like the anti-night attack. Anyway, she's using borrowed equipment right down in the PC and would like to get her own mini studio up and running. She's put together a few episodes and we'll be releasing them as the Kickstarter runs so people can get a taste for it. If you want to listen, check out the Bending Over Backwards podcast at YOLO420.com/BendingOverSwag. Jesus. If you think it's cool to want to contribute, by all means, go to YOLO420.com/YogaSwag. Much love, HH.
You know, it's not entirely opposite. You're not a fan of the yoga and the meditation, huh?
Oh, I have no problem with it. I had a problem with going to a place where I was forced to do it, like, which is also, by any understanding that I have of yoga, kind of not the point.
Like, that's not what yoga's about.
No, it's kind of like you choose to do it, like, and you open yourself up for it, and that's where you can
find...
You just
keep relaxing. You keep shouting like, relax, relax, still, still, relax!
Yeah.
No, I've started doing...
Do Germans and yoga?
Oh, geez. I don't have a pun. Sorry.
Done.
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 yeah, man. No, I'm trying out that meditation stuff. I'm a bit into it. I don't know. We'll see.
Here, wait. 2 seconds. We're gonna get right back to the meditation. I do want to read this. I mean, this is one of the things that we enjoy about our community, is that we support those when they are in need. This is a bonus Diamond Time. Lost but Broken writes, "Hey, friend passed away tragically in a murder suicide. She leaves behind 2 children. Please donate what you can spare for her funeral. bit.ly/funeralny. Anything you can spare helps." So there's a lot of stuff there. If you want to go take a look, then please take a look. You know, listen, we have a lot of nonsense here, but we like to take care of our own. So if somebody is in need, then go ahead and take a look at that page. If you can support, then go ahead and kick him something. Anyway, Brian, your problems. That was so unfair. I'm the worst person on the planet. I'm so sorry. I wanted to do good, and then there was no other way to do it, and I panicked and just and I decided to throw it on you. And
I think the worst part is I think you described it as a fun thing you wanted to do. Is that what you said?
No. A fun thing about our group, about our community, is that we take care of our own.
Got it. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm doing iPhone 6S reviews. Yeah, RR is correct. I really like my iPhone 6S. Look how fast it opens up the, look, real fast. That processor, though.
There is certainly something to, I mean, like, so there are two distinct elements, right? There's like the yoga and then there's the mindfulness. And very often they kind of go together. But they are definitely not the same thing. So people who are like meditating or like practicing what people call mindfulness or like understanding where other people are coming from and deliberating on that so you're not coming off rash is a different thing than like the physical practice of yoga, although they often go together. But you're saying that you are more into the...
Oh, I'm not into anything. I'm zero into any of this. I am actively predisposed to dislike all of this. I am doing my best to try it, and you know, mainly because you know, for all the reasons that I sometimes offload in this therapy program / Night Attack. You know, sometimes I get overloaded and stuff gets a little nutty. And it occurs to me that when I'm in those moments, I'm really robbing my family and my friends of my presence of mind and all that stuff. Man, I don't know if I'm outing him, but do you know what? Like, you hear a bunch of people talk a bunch of this crap, and they're like, "Yeah, I meditate. Why don't you just meditate?" It's like, I want a beer. Get out of my face. I ain't gonna meditate. And then what put me over the edge was Darren Kitchen was saying that he meditated and that it's all part of, you know, he works and he looks, yeah. Just outed myself. He looks so fit and happy. And calm.
All right, listen, this is a mutual Darren Kitchen admiration.
I'm not lying when I say that, right?
Oh no. Like, look at this out in he was out in Australia, right? And dude was up on stage. That's an old picture, by the way, because he's always
that's
had
back
a real
when he was miserable
face.
On the that inside.
No, that man's he's fit in the British terminology of handsome. He was on stage in Hawaii doing a keynote, not Hawaii, Australia doing a keynote. And
yeah, look at this.
And I'm like sending him, look at that.
Look at that guy, right? I want to be that. That dude is hanging out at a Chinese food restaurant telling you, like, yeah, I'm meditating. It's working out great. You could be me. And I'm like, oh, I can.
No, I was joking with him. I was sending him pictures that, like, he's just a couple inches on his hair away from being Tom Cruise in Magnolia.
Yes.
Is this passively equating mental happiness with just being
being
thin?
A total badass? Yes. No. He's the whole package. Because when you talk to him, you look into his eyes, and you know he's mentally fit as well. He's not going to tell you about how he's overloaded and working too many podcasts.
Brian.
He's going to tell you about how awesome he is and what he's doing. Hold on, look at these, he's jet skiing and all this beeswax. Why can't I be that guy? I'm gonna be like him.
Yeah, you know, Brian had epiphany. We're sitting there and we're all done.
Yes,
done.
Yes, yes.
Having conversations about how fat we are, you know. And
what?
And then he goes, yeah, like, you're supposed to be fat and happy, right? Let's just be happy.
Oh, yeah. No, I think what I said was we were both complaining about being fat. And I was like, hey, why don't we be happy being fat? Because we were taking turns like outing each other. Like, no, man, I'm so miserable and fat. I'm like this. I'm like that. And then it's like, what's the point of being fat and happy if you're not even happy? Let's just be happy. So at any rate.
Because we can't not be fat.
I want to be like Darren, so I'm trying
out. Hold on. Like, can we just pause?
Yes,
and that is what you guys just said, where you're like, you know, we had this whole thing where we just came to the conclusion we're just going to be happy. And if we can't be exactly in the physical shape that we can be, then we're just going to embrace who we are. Anyway, well, I looked at Derek Kitchen's Instagram and I'm like, F that, whatever, who cares? I'd prefer to be miserable. Anyway, high five, we both suck. Yeah, sure. It's very justifiable reasons why we're not in supermodel shapes. Also, like, by the average weight, you guys are both gorgeous. You are both gorgeous on the mean average.
I don't know how we got back here. Curse this program. No, my point is, I'm trying it out, and it's a real challenge for me, but I'm doing my bestie.
Well, that's what I always liked about smoking cigars, was like when I realized what I really liked about smoking cigars was that it was a hour blocked out of my day where I did controlled breathing.
Well, and actually that's a good point because I guess I'll tell the I didn't mean to tell the whole story here. I'm doing the Headspace app and yeah, you got a free trial, whatever, who cares? But
hey, Brian. You're allowed to try the Headspace app. In fact, I want you to subscribe to the Headspace app for 6 months right here.
I know. This is where I didn't want it to go. This is where I didn't want it to go because I'm sure they're spending all the money on all the advertising and on one of a billion people doing all this. And in fact, I just got some horse crap like, oh, you just did 3 days in a row. Do three more and you could give a free month to a friend. And I was just like, oh, God damn it.
I could use that free.
I know, and that's what I thought. I thought, well, damn it, now I got to do 3 days more so I can give a whatever. Darren, use offer code Darren5. Everybody tweet Headspace asking why code Darren5 doesn't work.
So we will,
and then Darren will actually appear in your living room and just make it all okay with his svelte figure.
So one of the things I dug.
By the way, I'm gonna go hang out with Darren like literally all day tomorrow.
Oh,
so
no.
he will get a real kick out of this final set.
I mean, there's some good metaphors in there, and it's like the whole time he spends, it's as though he's saying like, hey. I know none of this is working, and right now you're thinking none of this is working. That's okay, because look at this metaphor. Hey, so anyway, you feel better about feeling like it's not working? I'm like, I don't know, is it working? But I don't know, 2 weeks into it, it's kind of like,
I gotta say it's working.
Oh, geez.
Yeah, I do. Ooh, you're looking sexy up there on stage, Brian.
Kill it.
We might be at 2 1/4 inches.
Dong.
That's it. Hit the music.
Oh, man. What a hell of a day, man. We learned about magicians, megrims, and insecurities. We learned that Justin is our new favorite political correspondent.
Yeah. We learned that Darren Kitchen has a very svelte and sexy figure.
And it's all due to his Headspace. Use hashtag code Darren5 for your free 6 month trial.
I feel like even if we do real advertisements now, all of our codes need to be Darren5.
Well, and the best part is the idea that they give away a 6 month trial. Like, people are asking, like, I thought I got a 6 month trial with hashtag Darren5. Oh my God, they're already doing it.
Folks, thank you so much for joining us. Until next time. Die in a fire.
Oh, we'll see you next Tuesday, I think. But I wanna drink a warm glass of Drano.
Night attack. I love you.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.